pleasure of having Ben, with one N, my husband, joining us today on YouTube. How does it feel to be here?
It feels like I'm sitting in my living room with a camera.
Ben and I have done some YouTubes together before. When I first started my channel, I did vlogs, like an airport vlog, a Dallas vlog, Thanksgiving. But this is the first one we're doing like a sit-down Q&A. I went on my Insta stories and I asked you guys to submit some questions for Ben and I to answer on this YouTube. I've selected a few. We're gonna go back and forth.
I'll pick, you pick.
I'm gonna go on with the first question here. It's a real big, hard-hitting question, but it came up a lot. Do you regret getting married so young, and what age seems ideal to you now?
I hope they get easier.
They'll get easier. They'll get easier.
I don't regret getting married young because of who I married.
Okay.
But I would not recommend getting married young. I would say young would fall under the age group of like 24, 25 is about, I think, a personal opinion on where I think a healthy age to get married is.
Yeah, definitely. Like, I never like to say like I regret anything in my life, but circumstances happened again. Definitely would not get married so young. Getting married at 19 is way too young and would not want our kids to do that. But thank God we found each other and we have a real friendship, and that's what kept us going. In terms of age, I feel like in your late 20s is a good time. Ben thinks that's old because he wants to have babies right away. So I would say, yeah, I don't know, between like 25 and 28, I feel like is a good age, because then you have time to like be married before you have kids and think about that.
I'm actually curious about this answer because one of the few things I don't know yet myself.
Okay, now I'm curious.
What is your love language?
I have to read through what the love languages are. I know what his love language is. I'm gonna say my love language is words of affirmation. Like, I tell you, like, you look handsome, or love you, and things like that. So we have words of affirmation, quality time, physical touch, acts of service, and receiving gifts. I give receiving gifts. I'm gonna go with words of affirmation or quality time.
Quality time.
Okay, what's yours? What's that?
Giving gifts.
Receiving, you're giving acts, is that acts of service? I feel like that's acts of service.
Okay, acts of service.
He is, he loves giving gifts. If you guys are looking for, one of the questions here is some marriage tips. A very big marriage tip that we say is make your spouse a list of gifts that you want in all different price ranges so they always know something to get you.
Don't always make it so difficult.
Yeah.
Don't expect them to know what you want.
Exactly. Don't expect your partner to read your mind, know what you want. Let them know, and the surprise and the effort is them actually doing it.
Yep.
I never get Ben gifts because he never lets me get gifts. He buys things for himself, unfortunately. And in the beginning of our marriage, it really made me mad because I'm like, it's not fair. You get to give me gifts. I want to give you gifts. If he really gets enjoyment from getting his own gifts and he doesn't want me to, then that's on him.
You heard it here first.
You heard it here first. Even though I do know some of the gifts. Watches and cars, which are out of my budget right now, so. He only wants a big thing. What would be your early married advice?
Establish your independence. Try to be, you know, do as many things as you can on your own. And what your relationships are with your respective families. But a lot of times it's easy to just go there for dinner. Go there for the weekend. Try to spend as much time on your own together, you know, cooking dinner with each other, I don't know, doing your own thing to establish your own independence and not try to start off your relationship by being reliant on other people.
My marriage advice, which appeals to people of any age getting married, number one, you're gonna read marriage advice that says don't go to sleep angry.
You're like,
this is my, Ben's rolling his eyes because this is my go-to, but when we first got married, remember we would get in a fight and you would pass out in a moment and I would sit there and I would soup and I would think and I would Google what's wrong, blah, blah. And everyone said, don't go to sleep angry. Until I realized that that was just keeping me up. And most of the time you're just angry about something stupid because you're cranky and tired. If you wake up in the morning and you're still angry, talk it out. But chances are you're not gonna remember. So unless it's a big deal, go to sleep. You're just tired.
Good job.
I'm very passionate about it because I feel like there's all this information on Google and they tell you ideal marriage advice. And the number
no
one thing.
No one's ideal marriage advice is perfect for everyone.
Boom.
If you had to relive your honeymoon, where would you go?
Land this incredible honeymoon trip for us.
Which you still have the itinerary for.
Somewhere. To Hawaii for 5 days. We were supposed to go there. Like, it was gonna be amazing. We print out, this was back in the day when we booked everything through Travelocity.
And I believe it was Expedia.
Expedia. And Ben had the foresight.
Wow.
Right?
What a moment.
What a moment. To book travel insurance. And we printed out our boarding passes the night before, and it showed tropical thunderstorms. And it had the weather on it. It showed tropical thunderstorms the entire time we were going to be
now,
there.
This is late Saturday night for an early Sunday morning flight. So within 12 hours of our flight supposed to take off.
Yeah. So we had travel insurance. We're not going all the way to Hawaii, a 12-hour flight, to not be able to do anything and be stuck in our hotel. So quickly went back onto Expedia and bought a trip all-inclusive to Cancun, Mexico.
I remember, what did we do, Monday morning?
Yeah, we ended up having to leave Monday morning.
Right, I think we were up to 2 or 3 o'clock in the morning, Saturday night.
Figuring it out.
Sorting out the details.
Yeah, we ended up going to Cancun, it was really nice, it was chill, but if we were gonna do it again, what would you say? Would you go back to Hawaii or Fiji or Bora Bora or the Maldives?
Oof.
Bora Bora. Okay, cool. I'm down. Our 10-year anniversary is coming up, so. But I think then we're gonna do.
Tokyo.
We'll do a party. That I wanted to renew our vows, but then I feel like so many people get divorced after renewing their vows, so I feel like it's bad luck. So I just want to have a really fun, anniversary party. Giving you a heads up.
Okay.
What is one pet peeve of each other? I'm scared.
Bachata.
I probably know this. I know this.
You don't.
No, don't say that I'm messing you.
No.
Oh, okay.
You just said it, so I get another one now.
No.
Bacheva is the worst person to drive in a car with.
Oh.
She is worse than a driving school instructor. If there was a brake on her side of the car, we would still be parked in a parking lot somewhere because she just
here's
would
the
have
thing.
Her foot down. She expects you to maintain approximately 7 to 9 car, gap between you and the car in front of you.
No, 3 cars.
No,
you do 0.
No, 7 to 9. And on top of that, the use of the brakes are completely forbidden. Meaning, if I hit the brake, it's because
you were going too fast.
Was going too fast. Regardless of if somebody cut me off, or if they shortstop, or anything other, out of my control happens, if I use the brakes, it's my fault and it's because I was speeding.
Yeah, so I hate his driving. Ben's music habits. Ben likes to listen to music at all hours of the day, at any moment, and it's always, that I kind of got used to, but the volume at which he likes to listen to the music is too loud. I have very sensitive ears.
What is that thing that instantly made you into each other?
Aww.
Looking at you, I really admired how sort of down to earth and approachable, grounded you were. I really admired that expect anything, didn't take things for granted. And,
I didn't know that. I think when we first started going out, I think you were really spontaneous. And I've always been someone who doesn't just do things, I think them through. And Ben was more just we were 18, he was just let's do this, let's have fun. And to me that was really fun to be around, and I felt it pushed me more. I would say when we first started, that was the immediate turn on for me. It's gonna be the last question, guys. How we doing?
But we have more, so
let us know in the comments what you think, if you like this
segment. If Bacheva makes it to the Hamptons, from New York City to the Hamptons, without commenting on my driving once, we'll do it again.
I don't know how I feel about that. Okay, we'll end off with a question about Ben, because he kindly joined us today. Does Ben select his own outfits for events, or do you?
I select all my outfits for all the events, photos, places we go every single day. The only thing that I guess Bacheva has influence on is the color where if we're going specifically to an event where we're going to be photographed or she's gonna wanna take a picture, she'll ask that I coordinate with her.
I try to coordinate with each other, but I never pick out what he's wearing.
Thank you guys for tuning in. Such a really great experience. Really nice to get to know you a little bit better.
That's so sweet. If you enjoyed this, give it a thumbs up.
Hit the subscribe button.
Put in a comment below.
I just always wanted to say in the link in the description. There'll be a link to something in the description.
My TikTok, my Instagram.
Her TikTok, her Instagram, her Snapchat. Link in the description. Now we made it.
High five. That's all the real.